Right, so, and use an ID attribute to style an element. One cool thing about ID attributes is that, like classes, you can style them using CSS. However, an ID is not reusable and should only be applied to one element. An ID also has a higher precisivity importance in a class, so if both are applied to the same element or the same tag and have conflicting style, the ID will be applied. So we'll go with the ID instead of the class. Here's an example of how you can take your element with the ID attribute of cat photo element and give it a background color of green in your style element. So cat photo background color green. Note that inside your style element, you always reference classes by putting a dot in front of their names. You always reference IDs by putting a hash in front of their names. Try giving your form, which now has the ID attribute of cat form, a green background. Right, so I need so give the form. ID equals, so ID equals cat form, cat photo form. So now I want to give, aye, that's what you do. So inside the style tag would be hash cat photo form, space parentheses, and then background color colon. Need to put the parentheses in again, mind. Background color colon and a green background. So green semicolon. No. Go on. Green semicolon. So there's your background colour. Yabba dabba do. Right. Adjust the padding of the element. Now let's put your cat photo away for a little while and learn more about styling HTML. You may have already noticed that by all HTML elements are essentially little rectangles. Three important properties control the space that surrounds each HTML element: padding, border, and margin. So padding, border, and margin. That's padding, border, and margin. An element's padding controls the amount of space between the element's content and its border. Here we can see that the blue box and the red box are nested within the yellow box. Note that the red box has more padding than the blue box. When you increase the blue box padding, it will increase the distance padding between the text and the border around it. Change the padding of the blue box to match that of the red box. Right, so padding colour yellow, and I want to change the padding of your blue box to match that of the red box. Right, so 20 pixels, and I want to change that to 20 pixels. Hey!
Change of